Hi, this is Shruti N, Assistant Professor from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Maharaja Institute of Technology, Mysore. Welcome to C Programming Laboratory. Introduce 1D array manipulation and implement binary search. A binary search in C is an example of a simple process that can be used to resolve complex problems. As such, it's an important foundational concept that you will find in almost all good books on the C programming language. A binary search is an simple and very efficient searching technique which can be applied if the items to be compared are either in the ascending or in the descending order. Binary search algorithm applies to the sorted array for the searching an element. The search starts with comparing the target element with the middle of the element. If the value matches, then the position of the element is written, and in case the target element is less than the middle element of the array, then the second half of the array is discarded and the search continues by dividing the first half. The process is same when the target element is greater than the middle element. Only in this case, the first half of the array is discarded before continuing with the search. The iteration repeats until the match for the target element is found. The pros, the advantages of this binary search is, it's a fairly simple algorithm based on the divide and conquer approach, much faster in comparison to the linear search. Linear search requires n by 2 and n comparisons for the average and the worst scenarios. Binary search merely requires totally of log 2 of n and log 2 of n comparisons respectively for the average and worst case scenarios. To put it in simply, linear search on average requires 500,000 comparisons to be made for the set of million elements. Binary search on the other hand requires merely 20 comparisons, often available as an already implemented library routine. Here I'll take an example to explain the binary search in detail. Here I have taken totally 7 elements, and those numbers goes like this: 3, 6, 7, 11, 32, 33 and 53, and I have put it inside the array, and I want to search the element called 7. First, at the first step, I'll divide the array into half, that is low plus high by 2. Here the low is 0 and high is 6, that is 6 minus 1 is 7, low is 0 and high is 7, 7 minus 1 is 6, which is get divided by 2 will becomes 3. So mid element will be find at the position 3, which is called 11. Next, I'll compare this 11 with my target element, that is my key element 7. Is 7 is equal to midpoint element? No, 7 is not equal to 11. So search continues. I'll check, is mid element is less than or equal to 7? 11 is not less than or equal to 7. So the high will be get updated, that is 3 minus 1 equal to 2, which is your high becomes 2. Now your second part of the array will be discarded and only the first part of the array will be considered for the next step. So the low will be 0 and the high will be 2. Next, again just apply low plus high by 2 formula to get the mid element. So the mid will be the 1 and the element will be the 6, and again check, does your mid element is equal to your target element? 7 is not equal to the 6, so condition becomes false. Again check the condition, is mid element is less than or equal to 7? Yes, condition is true. So you want to now update the low variable, that is mid plus 1, which is equal to 1 plus 1, which is 2. Now the low is 2 and high is also 2. In the condition we have put low is less than or equal to high, so the condition again becomes true. Now again apply the formula inside the loop, that is mid element is equal to the mid target element. Yes, the condition is true, so set the flag to 1 and print the message search successful. And this is just an binary tree representation to make you to understand well. Here again the mid element is fine, that is 11, and next the right part of the tree is discarded, only the left part is considered, and in that left part 6 will be the mid element, and again since 7 is greater than 6, left part of the tree is discarded, only the right part is considered, and 7 is equal to 7, the message will be get printed that the target element is found at the position by printing the mid element plus 1th position. And the program, C program, goes like this. As usual, it starts with a header file, stdio.h, to support your printf, scanf and other functions, basic functions, and main function starts. And here the first, in the first line we have to declare and initialize the required variables, and here we will be dealing with only integers. I have taken up int data type and int array of size 20. Even you can work this program to 20 numbers. Here the array size is set to 20, and required variables like n, I, low, high, mid, key, flag, and if the flag is initialized to 0. At the first, your program will ask to enter the size of the array, and that can be read from your keyboard that is supported by your scanf, that is n. Next, your program again entered to ask you to enter the sorted array elements by using the for loop. We can read the elements to the inside the array, and next it will ask you to enter the key element that you want to search in your program in the array, so that will be read by the scanf. Next, your binary searching technique begins here. Initialize low to 0, high to n minus 1, put a condition while low is less than or equal to high, repeat the following step, that is mid is equal to low plus high by 2. If a of mid is equal to key element, then set the flag to 1 and break, that is stop your execution and print the message will be search is successful. If not, check if mid element is less than or equal to key element. If the condition is true, set the low to mid plus 1 position. Else, if the mid element is not less than or equal to key, set the high variable to mid minus 1 position. And next, after that, when loop stops, iteration stops, check whether the flag is set to 1 or not. If the flag is set to 1, print that search is successful and the key element is found at the particular position by printing the mid plus 1 the position. And else, if the flag is not set to 1, print that search is failed and the key element is not found. Here I have taken a sample example, that is enter the size of an array. I have entered 5 and I have entered 5 elements 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and I am interested to search the element called 6 in the array. So this is entered and the algorithm will be applied, your program will be worked for this. Since 6 is present inside the array, this it is getting me the message that search is successful and the key element 6 is found at the position 3. And in the second case, I have taken the same set of numbers inside the array, but I have entered the search element, that is 1. Since 1 is not present in the array, my program is giving me the output that search is failed and key element is not found in the array. Thank you.
Now, let us see how to run the program. First, here. First, in the GDB compiler, first type the program that what we have discussed. Now, once it is done, click on the run button. It is getting compiled. Now, it's asking to enter the size of the array. Just decide the size of the array as you wish. Here, I'll take the size of the array as 5. And just press enter key. Next, your program will ask you to enter the array elements in sorted order. For example, I enter 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10 as the 5 elements of the array. Now, the program is asking you to enter the key element to be searched. For example, if I want to search 6, I'll press 6 and and give the enter key. The search is successful. We are programming saying that the search is successful and the key element is found at the position 3. This is how the key element will be found using the binary search. For example, suppose if I run the program once again and I give again 5, and the elements will be 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. And suppose the search element that I'll give as 12. So it's saying that the search is failed because the key element is not found. This is how the binary search will search the elements in the array. Thank you.